as the storm blows through, and I need you. God gave me you for the ups and downs. God gave me you for the days of doubt. And for when I think I've lost my way, there are no words here left to say. It's true.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I am Courtney. This is Sangria, and you're watching Courtney's Mini Zoo. So here's what we're going to do today. So I did a pro and con crested gecko video, and that had a lot of hits. So I decided to do a pro con ball python video. So here's Sangria. He is my normal ball python. He just tried to lick me. I've had him for about one and a half years now. So I'm going to go ahead and get started. We're going to start with a con today. So the one first con I have is the big enclosure. So these guys, some people think they do fine in like a 40 gallon, but as adults, they do not do fine in 40 gallons. He is in a 75 gallon and he uses every inch of his space. He will stretch all the way out. He really loves his 75 gallon enclosure. So if you can go big because they really do use it. But that is a con for most people, and the reason that's a con for most people is because they don't have room for a 75-gallon cage, and a lot of times they get a ball python and they're thinking they can just stick them into tubs and whatnot. And yeah, you can stick them into tubs for breeding purposes that I don't agree with, but it happens. People do it. So that is the first con. And a lot of people don't have room for multiple enclosures. That's why I have one, because my room is full and I cannot have more than one 75 gallon enclosure in my room for a snake. So there's the first con. So the next thing is a pro, and the pro I have for this one is different morphs. So of course he's a normal, he was about $100-$110. But they have all kinds of different morphs around the world. You can get crazy colors in these guys, and that's a great pro, because if you want a snake that doesn't look like everybody else's, you can get a crazy morph. Now they are going to be a little bit more expensive than the normals, but I mean, you're going to have a really pretty snake. So ball pythons have like a lot of morphs. Not a lot of other snakes in the world have that many morphs as the ball python. So a little close up. All right, so we're gonna go on to the next con. The next con is one that really aggravates me and really stresses me out, and it probably does other people too, and it's hunger strikes. Ball pythons are known to go on hunger strikes. It's like something they're known for, and he goes on a hunger strike like once a year. He's gone like 7 months without eating. It's ridiculous. Ball pythons are known to go up to like a year, 2 years without eating sometimes, and that's crazy to think about. I don't know how their bodies can do it, but they can. As long as they're pooping and shedding, they are okay. So that's, what are you doing, Goldie? What are you doing? Just came here to get loving. So that's a crazy thing. But it's really aggravating, especially for first time owners. They've never had a snake, and you keep buying these rats and you keep trying to feed it to them, and then they don't eat. It's really aggravating. So they are very known for going on hunger strikes. It's very annoying when they do that. The next pro, though, is how docile they are. They are so gentle snakes. He has been the best boy. Now, I'm not going to say they cannot bite, because anything with teeth can bite, just like a dog, a cat, a horse, anything with teeth can bite you. They can bite. I've never been bitten by him. He's never offered to bite me. He's hissed like once, but that's when he's shedding and he was in a very bad mood. But nothing crazy like that. So they are very docile snakes. You can get them out. They're not going to want to get out and like cuddle with you if you like, nothing like that. But you can get them out and hold them, and they really love attention. They love to come out and explore and be held. So that's the next pro. Okay, the next the next con we have is they're nocturnal. So this is not a con for everybody, because I do stay up pretty late at night. I stay up till about 2-3 in the morning, so I get to watch his activity. But ball pythons are nocturnal, which means they are not going to be out during the day. They're going to be in their cave during the day, but at night they are all over the place. They're all over their cage, in their enclosure. He climbs at night. He does all kinds of stuff at night. So they are nocturnal, which does make it a con for some people, unfortunately, but they're very active at night. So if you want a snake, a ball python would probably be a good idea for you if you're a night owl like me and up doing more school. Saw something there. So the next pro is how active they are, so he is so active. At night, you will see him going all over his enclosure. Like I said, he uses every inch of that enclosure that he has. And if you get him out, he will slither all around the floor. I could try to get him out at least every other night and let him go in the hallway where everyone's asleep and just slither all the place while I'm supervising him, because he really enjoys that and he craves that. So I do let him do that. And then I do try to get him out when I do that and hold him some too. He is very well behaved with getting held. He is a big boy though, so it's hard to hold him with one hand, but I'm working it for the video. But a lot of people think ball pythons are boring and they're not active, but let me tell you, that is totally different with my guy and a lot of others that I've talked to about them. What are you doing? Okay, so the next con is eating rodents, which is an obvious, obviously they eat rodents, but that is a con for some people. So Sangria eats frozen thawed, which means they're frozen rats. You thaw them up in hot water, but some ball pythons have to eat live, and that is a big con for me. It would have been a huge con for me, but he ate frozen thawed from the person I got him from. Got him on frozen thawed, but it would have been a con for me. And even sometimes the frozen thawed are cons for people. So you do have to keep the frozen thawed in a freezer. Of course, I have a garage. I keep the rodents in so they're not in our freezer. But some people don't have that and it's going to have to go in their freezer. And then you have to warm them up and feed them. And dealing with rodents is kind of a con for some people because they would have to touch the rodents or they will see them get eaten and they just can't deal with it. I'm okay with it though. It's sad, but I'm okay with it. But some people, that would be a total set off, and either ball python or a snake in general might not be the best for you if that would be a con for you. So the next pro is easy to handle. What I mean by this is they are perfect size. The females get about 4 to 6 feet, and yeah, so he's a male and he's pretty long. He's about he's not quite as long as his enclosure, and it's a 75-gallon. I haven't measured him in a while, but after this video is up, I'm going to measure him and put up how long he is. But what I mean by this, ball pythons are not like boa size. They're not too large to handle. You can handle them pretty comfortably with one arm, and then my arms get a little sore from holding him right now. But you can do it, and they're not a skinny little worm like a corn snake, because corn snakes are like skinny little worms, and they're slithery, and they're very fast moving, and ball pythons kind of just sit there like this. Sometimes if I let him go, he'd be slithering, but they're not like fast moving. Like, I've seen corn snakes, and they're all over the place. Ball pythons are not like that. So the next con is high humidity requirements. And at first for me, when I first got him, this was a real con for me because I had trouble keeping the humidity in his enclosure and he was not shedding very correctly. But now I have his humidity all fixed up. I'm on top of the humidity situation, and he shed in big, long, full sheds, which is what you want with a ball python. But some people, especially if this is their first snake, they're going to have problems with keeping that humidity in, just like I did. But I got better at that. Everybody has their flaws when they forget they get an animal, and that one was mine. But yeah, humidity is kind of hard to keep in unless you know exactly what you're doing, but now I do. That's the other con. And a lot of people would probably stress out if their snake was having stuck sheds because they can get stuck in the eyes, and it's a mess. But that can be a definite con, so make sure you do your research on that. The next pro is they're cheap, which I do not mean that in any bad way or anything, but I mean, some boas and stuff are like $200, $300, and you can get a normal ball python juvenile for like $80, $60, which is a great deal for a juvenile. But I got him, he was like $100, $110, and I got him from my local pet shop, not pet store, but a local pet shop. They're like family owned, and they were great, great people. They had socialized him really well, and I met him and I just fell in love with him and had to get him from that place instead of getting it's like anywhere else. That's why I wanted this normal, because I just fell in love with him. It was just an instant connection. And the last con is they're very loud at night. Which again is not a con for me, but I've heard people say that like their ball pythons wake them up at night. And he is very, very loud, just like that. He is climbing all over the place. He's going through, I have like vines in there for him. He goes through the vines and he's very, very loud. But I do not mind at all. You see how he has been a trooper for this whole video. I'm about to stretch him out and let y'all see how long he really is, because we're done with the pros and cons. I want to say thank you so much for the people that submitted the ball python pictures from my Instagram Reptile Zone to be in this video. If I do any future pro con videos, I will ask for y'all to submit pictures to be in the video. So if you want a chance to be in the next video, go ahead and follow me on there and keep in touch. This is how long he is this way. And then, he's tightening. He is a chubby boy. If y'all can see, he's very chubby. He has, right now, he's on a hunger strike. So he is at 8 for about 2 months right now. But he's still shedding. There we go. This is how big the old man is. So we're going to go put him up. Thank you so much for watching my video. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much. A big thanks, shout out to my 88 subscribers. Y'all mean the world to me already. If y'all want to leave a comment down below and talk to me, I love talking to y'all and interacting with y'all. Please like this video and subscribe for more videos like this, especially if you like horses, dogs, cows, exotics, and more. All that is on my channel. Thank you so much. Here is Goldie. She was sitting on the bed behind me the whole video, and here is Baby sitting in the chair with me. Y'all just didn't get to see her. They are obsessed with me, and if a video is about anybody but them, they have to be in it somehow. So thanks for watching, you guys. So I'm sitting here trying to edit my ball python video, and Olaf keeps rubbing his head on my head. Olaf! He's such a sweet boy. He craves so much attention. Always when I'm busy. So cute. I'm gonna give himself a bath. Hi. Hi, cutie.
As the storm blows through and I need